morning. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, clothes we wear. In previous videos, we learnt about different types of clothes wear while working in a kitchen or while playing with fireworks. What are our basic needs? Food, clothing, and shelter are our basic needs. Clothes are made up of different types of materials that suit the weather of a place. People wear different types of clothes according to region, according to the season. Let us learn about the need for clothes, the different types of clothes, fibers used for making clothes, clothes we wear according to season, clothes we wear according to region, clothes for work, take care of clothes. Let us learn in detail about clothes. Basic need, art of weaving and stitching according to weather, region and profession. Need for clothes. Clothes need for protection from dust, protection from heat, protection from cold, protection from rain, protection from insect bite. Let us learn in detail about one by one. Basic need. Clothes are our basic needs. Importance of clothes is next to food. Early humans used animal skin to cover their body. They also used leaves of trees and bark of trees to cover themselves. Art of weaving and stitching. Gradually, people learn art of weaving and stitching of clothes. According to weather, region, profession, people wear different types of clothes according to region and season. People also wear different types of clothes according to their profession. Need for clothes. Protection from dust. Clothes protect us from dust. The dust may stick to our skin and sometimes small pores which are present on the skin are closed and it obstruct to give out sweat. Dust may contain germs. They may cause infections. Protection from heat. Clothes protect us from heat of the sun. And if we stay long time in the sun or if we will spend a long time in the sun, the uncovered parts of our body would tan. Protection from cold. Clothes also protect us from cold. We wear different types of clothes such as sweaters, etc. to protect us from cold. Protection from rain. Clothes also protects us from rain. These clothes are made up of special type of materials. They are waterproof materials. They help us do not get wet. Protection from insect bite. Some insect bites are poisonous and sometimes it is very painful. That's why we wear long-sleeved clothes to protect ourselves from insect bite. Clothes also protect us from mosquitoes. Mosquitoes causes different types of diseases such as malaria, pilaria, etc. But how these clothes are made up of? Up to now we learnt protection of clothes. But how these clothes are made up of? Clothes are made up of small threads called as yarn. A yarn is further made up of very long and thin strands called as fibers. But what are fibers? Fibers are natural sources. Here the fibers are very small, long, thin threads. Fibers are obtained from plants and animals, and some types of fibers are made in factories. So the fibers are mainly classified into two groups. Natural fibers, synthetic fibers. Natural fibers are again divided into two groups, plant fibers, animal fibers. Plant fibers are cotton, jute, linen. Animal fibers are silk, wool. Synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers means they are made up of chemical substances. So they are also called as man-made fibers or artificial fibers. Example for synthetic fibers are nylon, polyester. Let us learn in detail about one by one. What are called natural fibers? The fibers which are obtained from the natural source are called natural fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from either plants or animals. Plant fibers. The fibers which are obtained from the plants are called as plant fibers. The common plant fibers are cotton, jute, linen. Cotton is obtained from the fruit of the cotton plant. Jute is obtained from the stem of the plant. And linen is obtained from the stem of the flax plant. Animal fibers. The fibers which are obtained from animal source are called as animal fibers. Silk and wool are animal fibers. Silk is obtained from the silkworms, and wool is obtained from the sheep, goat, camel, etc. Cotton fiber. Cotton fiber is obtained from the fruit of the cotton plant. The fiber is separated from the seed by hand. Then this seed and cotton are separated. The processes used here are ginning, curdling, spinning, weaving. Ginning. Removal of cotton fibers from the seed is called ginning. Curdling. Separating the cotton fiber stuck together and cleaning is called as curdling. Spinning. Drawing yarn from the cotton wool is called spinning. Spinning is done on spinning wheel or charaka or on machines. Weaving. Making a fabric or a cloth is called as weaving. Let us see about jute fiber. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. The stems of the jute plants are immersed in water for few days. After few days, they will become soft. Then the fiber is taken out from the stems. Next is linen fiber. Linen fiber is obtained from the stem of the flax plant.